Hi there! In this video, we'll go over the basics of the repeater widget. You'll learn how to add widgets to a repeater, use its dataset to display data, and sort and filter the repeater. You can add a repeater by selecting widgets that are already on the canvas, right-clicking them, and selecting Create Repeater, or by dragging one of the repeater widgets from the default library. Repeaters have two parts: the items and the data set. Selecting the repeater opens the data set where you can add and edit data in the repeater. You can arrange how the repeater items are displayed in the style pane or toolbar. Let's change the data in the heading column of the data set. The heading column is connected to the heading widget, so these changes are automatically reflected in the repeater. Now let's make an edit to the repeater item. To do that, double-click the repeater to enter editing mode. Next, add a button widget. Double-click outside of the item to leave editing mode. Notice that the button appears in each item in the repeater. If we want the buttons to display the price of each item, we can do that in the dataset. First, add a new column to the dataset and name it Price. Then, click Connect Widget and select the button from the dropdown. Enter the price for each item, and notice the price is displayed on each button. For a more advanced way of setting text, such as dynamically formatting the price or adding tax, we can do that and much more using the Item Loaded event. Let's try adding a dollar sign and always showing two decimal places. First, disconnect the button from the price column. Then, head over to the Interactions pane. Click New Interaction and select the Item Loaded event. Then, choose the Set Text action and target the button. In the Value field, click the FX button to open the Edit Text dialog. Type a dollar sign in the text box. Next, click Insert Variable or Function and choose Item.Price under the Repeater section to insert the data from the Price column. Then, to give the price two decimal places, click Insert Variable or Function again and choose To Fixed under the Math section. Replace decimal points with the number 2, which will give the price two decimal places. Now we can see the formatted prices on the buttons. Now let's add some interactivity to dynamically sort the repeater rows. Let's add a button widget to the canvas and name it Sort by Price. Next, add a click or tap event. In the Actions dropdown, select the Add Sort action and target the repeater. In the Column dropdown, choose Price. Under Sort Type, keep alphanumeric selected, and under Sort Order, keep ascending selected. Let's preview to test it out. When we click the button, the repeater is sorted by price as expected. Now let's add an interaction that filters the repeater to only show items under $30. Let's add a click or tap event again, but this time choose the Add Filter action and target the repeater. Under Filter Rule, choose Price. Select is less than. Then choose text value and enter 30. Now let's preview to test it out. When we click the button, only the items under $30 are shown in the repeater. That's all for now. Thanks for watching and happy prototyping.